Hello everyone, welcome to the second lesson in the GoLang course. In this lesson, I will introduce you to primitive or the basic data types in Go. Before we start, let us discuss what are data types and why we need them. A data type is just a categorization of data. Think about why we write programs. Almost all the programs we write are to assist humans, right? In our daily life, we use different kind of data, from using numbers for monetary transactions like sending money or receiving money, to using strings to send text to our friends. Our brains can comprehend what the properties of each data types are and how to deal with them because we learned it through education in our school, right? So you know number multiplication, strings, how to write something, how alphabets can be put together to be considered string, right? A computer program has properties associated with data types, but it needs to know what data types we are using when we write a program. So to write a program that the computer can understand and to make it work, we use data types. In this lesson, we will cover what primitive or basic data types are, the primitive data types in Go, and then finally look at a small coding lesson to see how the data types are used. So let's begin. What are primitive data types? Go is a statically and strongly typed language. Statically typed language means that every variable or constant that we use in Go needs to have an associated type with it at compile time. So the compiler needs to know what type of variable or constant is when we are using it at compile time. Strongly typed means that once a type is associated with a variable, it cannot be changed from one type to another. You can cast it, but you cannot change the type of a variable or constant. For example, if you know a little bit of JavaScript, it's a dynamic type language. A variable can change its types throughout the life of the program. But this is not the case with GoLang. Each variable has to have one type, and that type can never change. This is very helpful in reducing the number of bugs in our program. Primitive data type, or the basic data types, as the name suggests, are the starter data types provided by the language. Composite data types, on the other hand, are made up from primitive data types. An example would be an integer in a Go is a primitive or the basic data type, but an array of integer is a composite data type. So an array of integer is made up of int values. Again, don't worry too much about what arrays are. We will cover them in the future lessons. The basic or primitive data types of Go can be categorized into three categories. We will dedicate lessons to each of the category to study them in detail. This is just an introduction. A Boolean data type is used to represent two states and two only. It can either be false or it can either be true. We usually use it when we need to make a decision to select one of the two options. So if the Boolean is true, we select one option. If not true, then we select the other one. Strings are used for text and code, like displaying a message to the user. In our first program that we wrote, we actually used a string hello world to print it to the terminal. There can be multiple or single line strings. We will look again at it in depth in the dedicated lesson for strings. Go actually supports Unicode strings, so this is a little different from if you are coming from languages such as C or C++. We will understand the differences again in the dedicated lesson. Number category is quite a big category, and it includes integers or ints, floats or floating point numbers, and complex numbers. There's also a concept of zero value in Go. Again, when we go into the coding lesson, we will look at the zero values. So without wasting any time, let's go into the coding session. So as I told you before, I'm going to give you a demo of different data types in Go. We will just go about the basic data types, and that too is limited to small set. In the following lessons, we will cover each data type in depth. So let's start with creating a main.go file here. And as we did with the last program, let's create package main, which is again an entry point, func main. So let's start by first creating a string variable, var my string string. So as you can see, var stands for variable. I'm telling the Go compiler that it's a variable. Don't worry about variables again. We will cover them in a different lesson in depth. MyString is the name of the variable, and string here is the data type of this MyString variable. We haven't assigned any value to it yet, so Go has a concept of zero value. For string, zero value is an empty string, right? So if I do fmt.println MyString and then go run main.go, you will see nothing is printed on the command line. Now let's assign MyString a value. MyString is equal to welcome to code and learn. Okay, so now MyString has a value. So let's try and print it again. Let's run our program again. Go run main.go. You can see it printed an empty line and then our new line, or the new string that we assigned the value to. Now let's create another variable of type int. Var my int. Again, here I'm telling the compiler that my int is a variable of type int. So you can see that I'm getting an error which says that my int is declared but not used. If you try to run a program where we have a variable that's declared but not used, we will get a compile time error. Go run main.go. So you can see it's telling you on line 12 in our code, my int is declared but not used. So I have to use it. And this prevents a lot of errors. Again, getting back to the topic, the data type of my int is int. Number values will have a zero value of zero. So since I have not assigned a value to it myself, if you try to use it, it will print zero. Zero value for int for number types is zero, okay? So I do fmt println my int. Now you can see the compiler error has gone away since we are using it. And once I type go run main.go, you can see it prints zero. I can again assign a value to it, my int 10. And then do a println again after assigning a value. Again, we will run go run main.go. And you can see first when the value is not assigned, it prints zero. And when I assign a value, it prints 10. Now let's see the next category, which is bool. Var my bool of type bool. Again, I'm telling the compiler that my bool is of type variable and the data type is bool. The zero value for bool is false. So as I told you in the lecture, a bool can either be true or it can either be false. And those are the only two values a bool can have. And the zero value for bool is false. So if I try to use it, fmt println my bool, you will see we get false printed to the command line. Let's change the value to true and then print my bool. Now you should see the value true printed. So this is the zero value before I updated it to true. And this is the value we updated it to. Now, as I said, my bool, which is a bool variable, can only have true or false value. And since Go is strongly typed, I cannot assign an int value or a string value. You can see that there is an error. Similar is the case with other values. So if I do my int and try to assign it a string, the compiler will complain about it. My string, and I try to assign 10, it will complain, but if I try to assign a different value, it is fine. So that's the basic introduction to data types in Go. In the next lessons, we will cover number data types in depth. So don't worry again if you don't understand anything from this lesson. Slowly, if you can code along, that would be great, and slowly you will understand it. Thanks for watching this lesson. If you have any questions, just post it a comment below the video. Or you can reach out to our Discord server. I hope you enjoyed it. Happy coding.